Right then guys, today I'm going to talk about rigs because this is one question I get asked on a daily basis. People all seem to be a bit confused about what rig to use, and today I'm just going to give you a bit of an insight into the rig that I've sort of used over the last 20 odd years of my fishing career. And take it from me, when I was a young lad getting into carp fishing, rigs back in those days was very confusing as well, and I wanted a rig that I had confidence in that I could take to lots of different venues, because back in those days I was fishing quite a lot of day ticket waters, and I just wanted something that I knew I could take to any lake, cast it out there and be confident that it's going to catch me fish. And over the last God knows how many years, I've taken the rig that I'm going to show you today all around the world, from some of the biggest lakes in Europe to some of the smallest lakes in England, and it's caught me fish. So I'm going to talk you through something I'm very, very confident in. It's not a fashionable rig, because what you have to understand is with carp fishing, there's an awful lot of companies out there that are promoting rigs to try and sell bits and pieces rather than to sell you some confidence. And what I'm going to try and do now is tell you about a rig that I'm super confident in. It's not a very difficult rig to tie up. It'll only take me a few minutes, and it doesn't use a great deal of components either. So I'm quickly just going to talk you through the components that you need. Today I'm going to be using a captive coated hook link, which I'll explain in a short while. We've got some of the Avid ring lead clips. We've got some of the towel rubbers that fit those clips. We've got some hair stops, and we've got some extra large liner liners, a pair of scissors, a baiting needle, and the new Armor Rock hooks from Avid as well. These are a size 4 that I'm going to be using. I'm going to be using quite a large size hook link as well as a hook, just to show you the sizes, just to show you something that you can see rather than using something that's very small. So what I'm going to do is take out one of the hooks, and there's 10 in a packet, and the reason I like the curve shank hooks is purely down to confidence. I've been using them for quite a few years now, different patterns. I like the style of the hook, I like the straight eye, I like the curved bend of the hook as well. I'm very confident in using them. So got the hook out, and I'm just going to get some hook link, and as I said before, I'm going to be using a 35-pound coated hook link, and I'm going to take roughly about 12 to 18 inches of this hook link, and then I'm just going to trim it off. And the reason I use the coated hook link is purely down to when I first joined Avid, because there was no braided hook link in stock, and I absolutely love braided hook links, and they sent me this coated hook link and said take a look at the inner core of it. So I took the outer coating off it, and on the inside is a lovely braided hook link, and I've just used it ever since. And the reason that I've used it ever since is not just because of what I've just explained, it's also because the actual inner core itself, although it's braid, it's actually quite waxy to feel, and it's not as supple as normal braid, and the actual components of the rig itself, the way it actually works, this braid, I like the flexibility of it, but I also like the semi-stiffness of it, because that will help the actual rig not tangle when you cast it out, because obviously everybody's very paranoid about casting braided hook links out, and there's obviously been some press about them tangling, but you don't get as many tangles with this braid. So I'm taking all of the outer coating off, stripping it all off, and there's a look at it all. It all comes off quite easy. You don't need a stripping tool to strip our coated hook link, and as I say, you're just left with this lovely waxy braided material underneath, and it's really nice. Got a lovely feel to it, it has, and I'm really, really confident with it. So now I'm going to get the hook, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to tie what's known as the knotless knot, and this is a very simple rig to tie. Simple knot to tie, I should say. You take one end of the braid, you slip it through the back side of the eye, then you form the hair down the side of the shank of the hook, and then you whip the rest of the hook link around the shank, moving slowly down towards the point. And I like a pivot for the hair to be opposite the point, and roughly you need about 13 turns to do that. And when you've wound it all the way down, you then get the opposite end of the hook link and push it back through the eye of the hook, and then you pull it all tight. And there you go. Nothing could be simpler than that knot, and that is a super strong knot. Now if we look at it closely, you can see that I've formed the hair down the side of the hook shank. And the reason that I do that is purely down to confidence, because many moons ago, I think it was about 1989, I read an article in Angler's Mail by an angler called Andy Little. And Andy Little turned around and said that if you put the hair down the side of the hook, there's a chance that the hook can turn a little bit more in the fish's mouth. Whether it's true or not, I don't know. But I've used it ever since and it catches me fish and I'm confident in it. So there you go, that's what rigs is all about. It's all about confidence. Now to finish the rig, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get one of these little liner liners, and these come in two different sizes from Avid. You've got the standard size or you've got the XL size. Now the XL size are for use with size 6 to 2 hooks, and obviously we're using a size 4, so these are perfect for this size of hook. And these are really easy to put on. All you do is get the braid and then thread it through the liner liner. And then you slide it down the line towards the eye of the hook. And then you just gently push that rubber over the eye of the hook. And then gently into place. As you can see, these liner liners create a slight curve, and you want that curve to be pointing upwards towards the point of the hook. And the reason I do that is because many years ago, there was a rig that was known as the bent hook rig, and it was proven to be a lot more effective at hooking fish than just standard rigs. And when you use our liner liners, that little curve helps to twist the hook itself in the carp's mouth and give it a better chance of hooking. But the trouble is with bent hook rigs, they actually cause a lot of mouth damage, which is why they've been banned on a lot of fisheries. And the reason we've created that bend is to create the bent hook rig itself, but without the damage that gets caused to the mouth of the fish, because the bend is there when the fish gets hooked, but when the line straightens, the bend disappears, so you don't get the mouth damage that the old original bent hook rig used to create. And the other reason that I use the liner liners like this is that they push themselves nicely over the eye of the hook, and that prevents any slippage from the hook link coming out of the eye of the hook, because with some hooks, one in a million, let's say, the actual O-ring doesn't always touch the shank of the hook, and sometimes, don't know how it happens, when the fish is hooked, it's twisting in the water, sometimes some hook links can squeeze themselves past that little gap that's created in the O-ring. So with a little bit of rubber over there, it just stops that from happening. So the next thing that I'm gonna do then is I'm gonna attach the actual hook link to one of these ringed leg clips. Now, Avid make two different types of leg clip. We also do a quick change one, but I'm just gonna be using the standard one today. And as you can see, very, very simple these are. And the hook link is gonna be tied to the little O-ring via what's known as a grinner knot. A grinner knot is one of these strangulation knots that when you actually tie it, as you pull it, it gets tighter and tighter. So it's perfect for braid. Really easy to tie up as well. I won't talk you through that knot. There's plenty of places that you can Google it on YouTube or some of the tackle manufacturers' websites. Tied. What I'm going to do is just pull it tight, test it. Something you always need to do with your rig is make sure that the knots are perfectly strong enough to deal with the fish that you're going to be targeting. Just going to trim that excess bit of line off so it's nice and tidy. And there's the hook link tied. And all that's left for me to do now is to sort the hair out. And today I'm going to be using some 18 mil wafter hook baits, and to tie the hair, I need a little baiting needle. And all I'm gonna do is measure the hair alongside the boilie. And I like a length of hair that's quite tight to the bend of the hook. And the reason for that is purely down to the fact that I want to know that when that fish hooks in that sucks in that bait, that the hook is going to be not far away from where the bait is, so I've got a better chance of hooking it. A lot of people like to use longer hair lengths, but for me there's a better chance of getting hook pulls when you do that, so I like it nice and tight. And all I'm going to do then is just get the bait and measure it to the length of the hair, and then I'm just going to tie a little granny knot in the end of it. And to finish tying the granny knot, that's where the baiting needle comes in handy, because you can slide it through. And there it is, all tied up. Now all that's left for me to do is trim, I should say, that bit off, and then attach the hook bait. I don't like flossing on hook baits. I don't like overcomplicating things. I'm just gonna slip the bait onto the needle and then slide it onto the hair. And then to finish it, I'm gonna use one of these camo hair stops. Does it matter whether you use a camo hair stop or a yellow hair stop or a brown hair stop or whatever? It's down to confidence. And I'm sure the longer you guys have carp fished, the more you'll realize that rigs is down to confidence, because if we've got the 10 so-called best carp anglers in the world studying now, talking us through their favorite rigs, you'd have 10 different rigs to tie up. But that's the hook end all sorted out. And then all I do now is I take one of these little tail rubbers, attach the lead on, and then that is basically the rig all tied up. I tie the line to the end of the lead clip, put the lead on, and then that is my favorite rig all tied up. Really simple, dead easy to use. And as I said at the start of this video, I've used it all around the world on lots of different waters. Now, some venues like Rainbow Lake or some snaggy venues, obviously I'd have to up the size of the hook, maybe use a size 2, or I'd even need to upgrade the size of the hook link. I might have to use something like Avid Shoctite, which is just down here, which is a 50-pound hook link. I use this on the continent, a lot of places like Morocco and France. On some day ticket waters in England, I might even go down to a size 15-pound hook link or a 25-pound hook link. The actual captive coated hook link comes in 15, 25 and 35, and it also comes in different colours as well. And it's all down to confidence. I use the browns, the darker browns, the greens. Today I'm fishing a venue that's quite clear on the bottom. There's a little bit of weed about as well, so I've gone with the green. It's what I'm confident in, and basically that is what rigs is all about. It's all about being confident, and once you're confident, you don't chop and change too much. You just sit there, put the rods in the right places, and wait for the carp.